Now for the industry we just created, which is that consumer's produce in the last video, we're going to make a good siding for it. Now to be realistic, you know, we want to use that Code 80 flex track, but at the same time it's too shiny, too perfect. The ties are spaced evenly, it's a black plastic look. We want to change that. So using the rail nippers, if you look at the ties carefully, you'll notice that evenly spaced is a hole, like a pinhole, and those are used for whenever you want to secure your track with the nails. But that's going to look unrealistic. So use your rail trimmers, you know, or your razor, you know, little saw blade, and cut out that one tie that has the hole in it. From there, you can move your other ties around. Have some closer together, some further apart. And that'll give you that staggered look of a siding that doesn't get, you know, well maintained. The next thing we want to do is get rid of that shiny black look. I've never seen black railroad ties, so instead we're going to spray paint it with a flat brown. And then whenever it's all dried, personally I like to use liquid nails to secure my track to the roadbed. Just a nice thin, you know, coating of liquid nails, and then find something heavy to hold the track down while it glues. For me, I like to use these old railroad spikes. A realistic siding will be a mixture of fine ballast, also a little bit of ground turf. You want to get a little tiny cup and you want to mix them all together. And that's going to give you the neglected siding look. The next things you're going to need is a mixture of water and Elmer's glue, maybe by 50-50 or less. Shake it up really good. And then you're going to use rubbing alcohol. And the rubbing alcohol and one of those eyedroppers is perfect. Now use a spoon and carefully put the ballast, you know, on top of the track. You're going to use a spoon and a paintbrush and even your finger to really make sure that the ballast is off of the ties. Get it off the ties, or else when it dries, you know, the glue dries it on, or you'll be chipping it away with a razor blade later. So get it all to go in between the ties. And then you're going to totally soak the track with the rubbing alcohol. Now first, when you put it on, you think you might have put too much on. Don't panic. You can even add a little bit more alcohol to it, but it will settle down. It will penetrate and it will always, you know, dry clear. So I did this whole section, and then I went over like some of the areas, you know, close to it that was missing some scenery. Right now in this video it's still wet, but it gives you an idea of how it's all going to look when it's all, you know, together. And that's our siding, ballasted, ready for freight. If you have any questions, ideas, suggestions, subscribe to my YouTube channel under DJ's Trains. Add your comments, and I'll be putting new videos up usually about once a week as we make progress on industrial railroad centered around Pittsburgh. Thanks.